Thank you. relative of William Clayton, and Dale Uselag. He wrote Come Come Ye Saints. He wrote the words. The music has been here a long time, but the words was, he was asked by President Brigham Young to make a song that the saints could, he knew it was going to be tough. He knew it was going to be tough, and he wanted a song that would raise their spirits each time. And so this was created at that time. I'm going to tell you a short story here. Come, come ye saints. Across the plains of Texas, and further still to the east, among the green hills of Oklahoma, could be seen the Indian villages. And here, two young elders had come, beginning one of their meetings with a hymn of the pioneers, Come, Come, Ye Saints. A stalwart Indian chief, upon whose brow rested the snowy white locks of 100 winters, and whose numerous wrinkles, plowed deep by the hand of time, left their lines written upon his countenance. He stepped forth and said, that is my song. Where did you get it? The elders related the story of the hymn. Then they asked the old chief how he claimed the song. 3 and 4 score bright summers, moons ago, he began, my tribe was on the warpath. Our homes had been taken from us from the pale faces who came from the land of the rising sun. We burned 2 camps. We saw another in the distance. We were going to burn it. I was a young chief of 20 winters. My braves followed me to the hilltop. We saw wagons and oxen in a camp. We watched and we waited. We saw the pale faces dancing around the campfire. Then they made a circle and knelt down in prayer to the Great Spirit. They put out the lights. They went to bed. In the darkness, we heard them singing this song. Our hearts were touched. We could not raise our arrows. We went back. I played the song every day on my old violin. It brings me to the Great Spirit. You say those pale faces were your grandfathers and grandmothers. They never knew that this song saved their lives that night. Thank you. coming up. Don Benson, I hope it's one of yours.
Thank you. 1949, 64 years ago, a skinny kid from the 6th, 7th Ward in the All-Church basketball tournament that year not only represented the ward in the finals that tournament in the old Deseret Gym, he was up against my old Lakewood ward in the Los Angeles Valley, in California, and I'm sorry to say that we beat him. Oh. Talent comes in many forms. This skinny kid has been a fan of mine for 64 years. It was a moment for me. Sperry, thank you for developing the talents that God gave to you and preparing yourself throughout your life. We're so grateful your sister didn't want to take private piano lessons and that you had to take the bus. Thank you, though, for developing this talent and doing so well in sharing the beauty that is within inside of you with us tonight. Thank you very much. You're truly blessed. Harold Waite, would you do us a benefit? Oh, one other thing. We're so glad that this has been recorded. Last week, there was a program of 40 years of wonderful performances. When they make it to 50 years, we'll make sure that's in the program.
I failed to mention he was one of the five on the All-Church tournament team that year. I can't remember everything.